from the Mighty Ducks to the Breakfast Club, to St. Elmo's Fire, Stakeout, Young Guns, Rated X, The Outsiders, and of course, one of my all-time favorite films, Repo Man. Please welcome to the stage, Emilio Estevez.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I think that there are enough of us here tonight who remember the days before we cut film digitally, when editors used the splicer, tape, and trim bins, and how important that trim bin so often was. Remember those 12 frames that you tossed in that bin? The frames that you thought you'd never need again, which were now somewhere in there, probably near the bottom, but you did need them, so you'd spend 15 minutes rummaging through that bin, searching for that piece of film, and once you found it, that half a second would be repatriated to the reel you were working on, and in the end, it would make all the difference to the scene. Tonight's recipient of the Career Achievement Award knows just how important those 12 frames can be, how the simple addition or subtraction of a half a second can affect the balance and the rhythm of a moment, extend an actor's look, the stillness of a landscape, the heartbreak of loss. I met Richard Chu nearly 2 decades ago, and we've collaborated on 3 pictures. And as a writer, director, actor who could occasionally become entrenched in my original intent, Richard would often remind me about the difference between the film you write, the film you shoot, and ultimately the film we would cut. Richard's instinct to move or reposition scenes would oftentimes help create better transitions and improve the overall storyline. Now, this relationship between the editor and the director is unique and unusual. You spend 8 to 10 hours of every day for many months in a small, dark room with a person who is neither your spouse or your life partner. But that creative bond that occurs during that process is in many ways unbreakable. Working together that to make something, for better or worse, will outlast most of our marriages. And there's no editor whom I'd want to spend those days, those weeks, those months in that small, dark space than Richard Chu. His wit, his attention to detail, his commitment to social justice in his work and his life, and his desire to explore humanity make him not only one of the greatest film editors of our time, but truly a valuable asset for any filmmaker. And it also doesn't hurt to tell an impatient producer or a studio executive to back off, because I'm in the room with one of the Oscar-winning editors from the original Star Wars. A well-deserved Academy Award, which I watched, presented live, during the 1978 Oscar ceremony. So now, let's take a look at the incredible work of Richard Chu.
Hello, Pittsburgh! We got a great show for you today. A big show, a king-size show!
Just take those old records on the shelf. I sit and listen to them by myself.
One thing I've learned in all my years, sometimes you gotta say, what the fuck?
I mean, what do you really want from a guy?
Looks, security, caring. Someone who says gazoon tight when I sneeze. Although, I prefer bless you.
Bless you.
Thank you.
Take very good care of this young man. He's one of the 10 finest minds in the country.
Someday I hope to be 2 of them.
Jump up in the air and stuff that son of a bitch in there, Chief.
Just raise your hand up, Chief. We have that. Chief! The Chief!
Oh, it's a lot of fly ball and even less than ever!
It's going! It's going!
It's going!
you don't ever throw down with your homegirl over a guy. Guys come and go, they ain't worth it. We girls need new skills, because by the time our boys are 21, they're either in prison or disabled or dead.
What's going on?
Senator Kennedy's been shot.
Surely we can learn at the least to look around at those of our fellow men. And surely we can begin to work a little harder to bind up the wounds among us and to become in our hearts brothers and countrymen once again.
We know that you know, Mr. Cole. We'll be listening to you.
He'll kill you if he gets a chance. I'm not afraid of death.
I am afraid of murder.
Dying is easy. Comedy is hard.
It's against the law to burn anything except trash in your own yard, Liam.
It is trash.
Big man with a gun! What are you gonna do, huh? You're an
assault!
Looks like the Oneaters.
The Runaways have the most chance of any group I've seen to do what the Beatles did, to tear this world apart.
Get your little ass ready.
Cheers to whoever cut that reel. Really well done. It's my honor and a privilege this evening to present the Career Achievement Award to Richard Chu.
Thank you. You can remain standing. You know, even though you prepare for this, you're never ready for a moment like this. I'm actually a very accomplished public speaker. For the Rotary Club. I thank you, my fellow editors and Ace. I count myself among the fortunate to have been able to do the work I love doing for many years, editing movies. What is incredible about tonight, along with this award, is that I was born and raised in a house just a mile from this stage. In a figurative sense, it took me more than 80 years to go 1 mile. Kind of slow, you know? My house was on a block that was somewhat drab. There was a gas station on one corner, a parking lot for school buses on another, some houses in between, and a commercial printing press in the middle of the block. So our household was pretty basic. A couple of things connected us to the outside world. There was the family radio in the living room, and there was a telephone with a party line. And if someone had an urgent message for us, they would send a telegram. They would call Western Union, and a messenger would deliver it. It wasn't until we got our first TV set when I was 9 that I got to see movies on a Telvinch screen. And from them, I saw how adults outside my family spoke to each other and behaved, sometimes badly, sometimes with honor. I saw how couples fell in love and fell out of love. But those movies on TV were old and sometimes irrelevant to the world as I knew it. Cut forward 15 years. In my second year of law school, I saw a film called Nothing But a Man, starring Ivan Dixon and Abby Lincoln. It impacted me greatly. It showed racial inequality in the guise of a love story. So I saw how social context gave the story meaning. That's when movies became relevant to me and made me realize that I wanted to learn how to make movies that mattered. So I quit law school and looked into a way to work in filmmaking. With that seriousness of purpose, I started in documentaries, first as a cameraman gathering images. But after a while, I found it was more powerful to arrange those images to tell a story. I gravitated toward editing as I moved on to feature films. The first two were dramas, and the third was this fantasy space opera that some of you may have seen. Then the cinema gods spun me around and did me a 180 and redirected me to comedies. It was a genre I hadn't planned for, but it fit me well. Equal in value to my award tonight is the fulfillment I have felt throughout my career. First at the editing bench, then at the keyboard. And to top it off, I got to work with some of the funniest, smartest, and most dedicated people in the profession. In honoring me tonight, you're indirectly honoring all those who have helped me throughout my career. There have been the insightful agents who have hooked me up with the right projects. There have been producers, directors, and fellow editors who've taught me, indulged me, and enabled me to do what I love doing. Then there have been dozens of assistant editors who have organized my workflow. And they've shared the weight of finishing a film. And you know how heavy that could be. And most of all, there's been my family, both immediate and extended, giving me TLC and a sense of proportion in the grand scheme of life. Back in the day, the legendary studio boss Samuel Goldwyn said, "Movies are for entertainment. If you want to send a message, call Western Union." True, movies are for entertainment, thank goodness. May they continue to thrill us, make us laugh, bring us to tears. We as editors play a big part in making that happen. But these are fractured and fragile times. And I'm thinking that maybe we could do both, entertain and send a message. Perhaps we can use movies to emphasize our common humanity. Maybe we can use movies to encourage the better angels of our nature. Thank you very much. I taught you all to have remained standing, so. Hey, thank you so much. You know, onward to better things with what we do, because it's in our hands, man. We can change it. We can change it.
To present our next